Hello again, YouTube. It's Skylar. Welcome back to my face. And in today's video, I'm going to be discussing the topic of cisgender actors playing transgender roles. Now, more recently, I've done some homework on this, and I've seen both sides of this argument, because there has been a little bit of a controversy as to whether or not a cisgender person, if it's appropriate for them to play the role in film or show as a portrayed as a transgender individual. And today I'm just going to be giving my thoughts on this. So, there are not that many transgender actors. And this is due in part to the fact that there are not that many transgender people. However, this also is conflated by the fact that transgender individuals experience a lot of workplace discrimination. So, up-and-coming actors who are trying to get their break, typically, with the current state of how employment works, people can be disqualified simply for the fact that they're transgender. Now, this isn't always immediate, and this isn't always the case. But in certain instances, transgender people face discrimination in the workplace, either by not being hired or being fired on the basis of being transgender. And these two combinations, when you also include that there are a limited number of roles that can be played by actors, severely limits the amount of people that would qualify to play transgender roles. Now, do I think it's appropriate for a cisgender person to portray a transgender person in film or TV? No, I don't. And that's not to say that I think that the actors that portray transgender people, who are they themselves cisgender, have any malintent or are trying to stereotype transgender people. But when you consider that transgender people face workplace discrimination, it does say something when you have cisgender people playing transgender roles, when those roles could be filled by transgender actors who may have not gotten the opportunity to partake in the acting role. Now again, I'm not saying that cisgender actors playing transgender roles necessarily have anything against transgender people or that they are trying to portray them in a negative way. But if we're going to go down the road of having transgender characters appear in film, TV, and other such media, it is important recognizing that, yes, those roles should probably be filled by the people that understand them the best, which is transgender people themselves. So basically, the moral of this story is if you want transgender roles in movie and film, just hire transgender people for them instead of trying to pick from the group of cisgender people who would have to go back and then educate themselves on the issue of transgender and then talk to transgender people and interview them, and when all of that could just be bypassed and just have a transgender person do the role. And this just goes to the larger discussion of this is another example of workplace discrimination. You have transgender people who would like to fill roles in employment that are not given that opportunity because they're a transgender, And then you end up with a situation where if the need arises for a portrayal of a transgender individual, that role cannot be met with an authentic transgender person. So I think if media is one example, it shows that workplace discrimination against transgender people is still very real, and unfortunately, a lot of transgender people have experienced this and their voices cannot be heard. So that's my take on that. So with that said, I hope you all have a wonderful rest of your day. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe to my videos for more amazing content. And I will see you all tomorrow in the next video. Bye.